Modern letters, word problems. Problem set 5. Choose the correct alternative answer and fill in the blanks. If all pairs of adjacent sides of a quadrilateral are congruent, then it is called dash. Out of the given options, you have to select the correct one. You are given rectangle, parallelogram, trapezium and rhombus. So the correct answer will be rhombus. If the diagonal of a square is 22 square root of 2 centimeters, then the perimeter of the square is dash. In triangle ABC, by Pythagoras theorem, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Hypotenuse square is equal to one side square plus other side square. Now put all the values there. So you get 22 square root of 2 the whole square. Please correct it. It is 22 square root of 2 within the brackets. The whole square is equal to AB square plus AB square. In triangle ABC, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. The question is wrong. If the diagonal of the square is 12 root 2 centimeters, then the perimeter of square is dash. So here you have to substitute instead of AC, 12 into square root of 2. It is given 12 square into square root of 2. Please correct it as 12 square root of 2. 12 square root of 2, the whole square, is equal to AB square plus AB square. That is equal to AB square plus AB square is equal to 2 into AB square. And here, since it is a square, all the sides are equal. That's why instead of BC, we have substituted AB. And 12 square root of 2 the whole square can be written as 12 square into square root of 2 the whole square. 12 square is 144, square root of 2 the whole square is 2. Now, from the left hand side, bring the 2 to the other side, will be upon 2. 2 and 2 will cancel and you will get 144. AB square is equal to 144, therefore AB is equal to 12 centimeters. Now we have to find perimeter of ABCD. So perimeter of the square is 4 into side, so it is 4 into 12, that is equal to 48 centimeters. So the answer is C, which is 48 centimeters. Now coming to the third one, if opposite angles of a rhombus are 2x degrees and 3x minus 40 degrees, then the value of x is dash. Since opposite angles of a rhombus are congruent, 2x is equal to 3x minus 40. From this you have to find the value of x. Bring 2x to the right hand side, it becomes minus 2x. 3x minus 2x will be x. And bring minus 40 to the left hand side, it becomes plus 40. So when you read it, it becomes x is equal to 40 degrees. So the answer is D, which is 40 degrees. Now coming to question number 2. Adjacent sides of the rectangle are 7 cm and 24 cm. Find the length of its diagonal. Now draw the figure, mark everything. Now let ABCD be the rectangle. AB is equal to 7 cm, BC is equal to 24 cm. In triangle ABC, measure of angle B is equal to 90 degrees because angle of a rectangle. Now triangle ABC is a right angle triangle, so we can apply the Pythagoras theorem, apply it and find out AC. We get AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Substitute the values. You get AC square is equal to 625. Now AC will be square root of 625, taking square root on both the sides. So AC square root of AC square will be AC, and square root of 625 will be 25 centimeters. Therefore, the length of the diagonal of the rectangle is 25 centimeters. Now coming to question number 3. If diagonal of a square is 13 centimeters, then find its side. So draw a square, mark the diagonal as 13 centimeters. Let quadrilateral PQRS be the square of side x centimeters. Therefore, PQ is equal to QR because sides of a square, that is otherwise equal to x centimeters, take it to be equation number 1. Therefore, in triangle PQR, measure of angle Q is equal to 90 degrees, angle of a square. Therefore, now triangle PQR is a right angle triangle. Therefore, PR square is equal to PQ square plus QR square. Hypotenuse square is equal to one side square plus other side square. PR square, it is otherwise 13. 13 is equal to x plus x because by 1. Sorry, 13 square is equal to x square plus x square. Please mark the squares that is missing. PR square, PR is 13, so PR square will be 13 square is equal to PQ square. PQ is x, so PQ square will be x square. QR is x, therefore QR square will be x square. So x square plus x square will be 2x square and 13 square will be 169. Now you have to find out the value of x square. Keep x square on one side, take 2 to the other side. Multiplication becomes division. So it is 169 upon 2. Now taking square root of both sides, you get x is equal to square root of 169 upon 2. Square root of 169 is 13 and square root of 2 is there in the denominator. Now we have to rationalize the denominator. So multiplying the numerator and denominator by square root of 2, you get 13 root 2 upon square root of 2 multiplied by square root of 2 in the denominator becomes 2. Because it is square root of 2 square, which is otherwise 2. Now 13 upon 2 is 6.5, so it is 6.5 square root of 2 centimeters. So the answer is the length of the side of the square is 6.5 square root of 2 centimeters. Coming to the next problem, question number 4. Ratio of two adjacent sides of a parallelogram is 3:4 and its perimeter is 112 centimeters. Find the length of each side. Draw the figure. Now it is given the ratio formula. Ratio of two adjacent sides of the parallelogram is 3:4. So ratio of two adjacent sides of this parallelogram STUV will be 3:4. Let us take the common multiple to be x. So ST will be equal to 3x centimeters and TU will be equal to 4x centimeters. Therefore, ST is equal to UV is equal to 3x centimeters. Because opposite sides of the parallelogram are congruent, so ST is equal to UV is equal to 3x centimeters and TU is equal to SV is equal to 4x centimeters. Opposite sides of the parallelogram, take it to be equation number 1. Now, perimeter of STUV will be 112 because it is given. Sum of the lengths of the sides you have to take. So, ST plus TU plus UV plus SV is equal to 112. Now, substitute the values there. You will get 3x plus 4x plus 3x plus 4x is equal to 112. This is from equation 1. Now, add it, you'll get 14x. 14x is equal to 112. Therefore, x is equal to 112 upon 14. Because 14 multiplied by x, multiplication becomes division when it is taken to the other side of the equal to sign. Therefore, x is equal to 8. Now, substitute it in the previous statement which we have written. So, ST is equal to UV is equal to 3x. Instead of x, you will get 8. So, 3 multiplied by 8, which is otherwise equal to 24 centimeters. TU is equal to SV is equal to 4x. That is equal to 4 multiplied by 8, which is equal to 32 centimeters from equation 1. Therefore, the lengths of the sides of the parallelogram are 24 centimeters, 32 centimeters, 24 centimeters, and 32 centimeters. Coming to the fifth problem. Diagonals PR and QS of a rhombus PQRS are 20 cm and 48 cm respectively. Find the length of side PQ. Draw the figure. Figure is not given. Draw the figure. PQRS is a rhombus is given. PR is equal to 20 cm and QS is equal to 48 cm is given. Therefore, PT will be equal to half of PR because diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other. So PT will be equal to half of PR. Substitute the value. So that will be equal to half multiplied by 20, which is equal to 10 cm. Also, QT is equal to half of QS. The same reason, diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other. That will be equal to half multiplied by 48. That is equal to 24 cm. Now, in triangle PQT, measure of angle PTQ is equal to 90 degrees because diagonals of the rhombus are perpendicular to each other. Therefore, PQ square, we can apply Pythagoras theorem because it became a right angle triangle now. So, PQ square is equal to PT square plus QT square because hypotenuse square is equal to one side square plus other side square. Substitute the values here. So, 10 square plus 24 square, which is other way, is equal to 100 plus 100 plus 576, which is equal to 676. Now, taking square root of both sides, you get PQ is equal to square root of 676, which is other way is equal to 26 centimeters. So, answer, the length of side PQ is 26 centimeters. Now, coming to the sixth one, diagonals of the rectangle PQRS are intersecting in point M. If measure of angle QMR is equal to 50 degrees, then find the measure of angle MPS. Here also you have to draw the figure. Figure is not given, so you have to draw the figure. Now PQRS is a rectangle, therefore PM is equal to half of PR because diagonals of a rectangle bisect each other. Take it to be first equation. MS also is equal to half of QS because diagonals of a rectangle bisect each other. Also PR is equal to QS. Take it to be third equation because diagonals of a rectangle are congruent. Now from equations 1, 2 and 3, combine equations 1, 2 and 3 and see. Now see, in the third equation we have PR is equal to QS. Now look at the first and second equation. Half PR will also be equal to half of QS. So the right hand side, so the first and second equation becomes the same. So the left hand sides are also equal. So PM is equal to MS. Take it to be the fourth equation. Now in triangle PMS, PM is equal to MS from the fourth equation. Therefore, now in the triangle PMS, we have the triangle to be the isosceles triangle because two sides are congruent. Therefore, we can apply isosceles triangle theorem. So the opposite angles also will be congruent. So the measures will be equal. So measure of angle MSP will be equal to measure of angle MPS will be equal to some x degrees. Take it to be fifth equation. Now, you also have vertically opposite angles. So, measure of angle PMS is equal to measure of angle QMR is equal to 50 degrees because they are vertically opposite angles. Now, in triangle MPS, some of the measures of the angles in a triangle is 180 degrees. So, if you sum up all the measures of angles, you will get 50 degrees plus x is equal to 180 degrees. From equations 5 and 6. Now x plus x is 2x. Take 50 to the other side of the equal to sign, so it becomes 180 minus 50. Now 2x is equal to 130, therefore x will be equal to 130 upon 2 because 2 multiplied by x, when it is taken to the other side of the equal to sign, it will become divided by 2. 130 divided by 2, which is other way, is equal to 65 degrees. So your answer will be measure of angle MPS is equal to 65 degrees. Coming to question number 7. In the adjoining figure, if segment AB is parallel to segment PQ, segment AB is congruent to segment PQ, segment AC is parallel to segment PR, segment AC is congruent to segment PR, then prove that segment BC is parallel to segment QR and segment BC is congruent to segment QR. Figures given, figure 5.42 in the textbook in page number 74. So you have to write the proof now. Consider quadrilateral AB QP first. You see in the figure quadrilateral ABQP. Segment AB is parallel to segment PQ is given. Segment AB is congruent to segment PQ is given. Therefore, quadrilateral ABQP is a parallelogram, because a quadrilateral is a parallelogram if a pair of its opposite sides is parallel as well as congruent. Therefore, segment AP is parallel to segment BQ, because ABQP is a parallelogram, opposite sides of the parallelogram are congruent. So, segment AP is parallel to segment BQ, opposite sides are parallel as well as congruent. Opposite sides of the parallelogram AB, QP will be parallel as well as congruent. So, segment AP is parallel to segment BQ. Now, you have to look at quadrilateral ABQP in the figure. So, segment AP is parallel to segment BQ, and also segment AP is congruent to segment BQ. Take this to be first and second equations. Now, consider quadrilateral ACRP and discuss similarly. Segment AC is parallel to segment PR is given, and segment AC is congruent to segment PR is given. A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if a pair of its opposite sides is parallel and congruent. Therefore, quadrilateral ACRP is a parallelogram. Hence, segment AP is parallel to segment CR, and segment AP is congruent to segment CR, because opposite sides of the parallelogram. So, take this to be third equation and fourth equation. Now, similarly, consider quadrilateral BCRQ. Segment BQ is parallel to segment CR. Segment BQ is congruent to segment CR. Therefore, quadrilateral BCRQ is a parallelogram. A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if a pair of its opposite sides is parallel and congruent. Therefore, segment BC is parallel to segment QR, and segment BC is congruent to segment QR, because they are opposite sides of the of a parallelogram. Now, question number 8. In the adjoining figure, quadrilateral ABCD is a trapezium. AB is parallel to DC. Points P and Q are midpoints of segment AD and segment BC respectively. Then prove that PQ is parallel to AB, and PQ is equal to half of AB plus DC. Now, the figure is given in your textbook. It is figure 5.43 in page number 74. You are given quadrilateral ABCD is a trapezium. You have to prove PQ is parallel to AB and PQ is equal to half of AB plus DC. You are also given points P and Q are midpoints of segment AD and segment BC respectively. You have to prove that PQ is parallel to AB and PQ is equal to half of AB plus DC. Now, for this, make a construction. Join points A and Q. Extend segment AQ. And let it meet, produce DC at R. DC is produced, and extend segment AQ. Let it meet at R. So, segment AB is parallel to segment DC is given, and let us take line BC to be the transversal. Segment AB is parallel to segment DC is given, and let us now take segment BC to be the transversal. Now, we can see the alternate angles. Therefore, angle ABC is congruent to angle RCB. Alternate angles are congruent by the alternate angles theorem. When the lines are parallel, we have the alternate angles to be congruent. So, we have angle ABC is congruent to angle RCB. But what is the other name for RCB? The other name is RCQ. They are having one and the same. That is the name of one and the same angle. Because Q lies between B and C, we can write angle RCB as angle RCQ. Now, take this to be the first equation. Angle ABQ is congruent to angle RCQ is taken to be the first equation. Now, in a triangle, now that problem is continued. So, I have taken a part of the figure now. In triangle ABQ and triangle RCQ, angle ABQ is congruent to angle RCQ from equation 1. Segment BQ is congruent to segment CQ, because Q is the midpoint of segment BC. We also have vertically opposite angles, angle BQA and angle CQR. They are congruent. So we now we can apply ASA test because the side is the included side between the angles. The side is the included side between the angles. So we can apply ASA test. So by ASA test, triangle ABQ is congruent to triangle RCQ. Now we can see the corresponding sides of congruent triangles. Segment AB is congruent to segment CR. You take it as equation number 2. Segment AQ is congruent to segment RQ, corresponding sides of congruent triangles. Now segment AQ is congruent to segment RQ, look at the figure. So since the segments are congruent, the lengths are equal. So AQ is equal to RQ, so Q is the midpoint of segment AR. Take it to be the third equation. Now coming to the next one, in triangle ADR, points P and Q are the midpoints of segment AD and segment AR respectively. Given and from equation number 3. So look at ADR now. So here segment PQ is parallel to segment DR by midpoint theorem. And also PQ will be half of DR by midpoint theorem. Because the midpoint theorem states that the segment joining midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side and half of it. So PQ is the segment joining the midpoints of side AD and AR in the figure. So it is parallel to the third side and half of it. Third side is DR. So PQ is parallel to segment DR and also PQ is equal to half of DR by midpoint theorem. Since PQ is parallel to segment DR, we can also write DR as DC because C lies between D and R. So segment PQ is parallel to segment DC. Take it to be the fourth equation. But segment AB is parallel to segment DC is given. Take it to be the fifth equation. Now from 4 and 5 we get, look at the right hand side. Segment DC and segment DC. The segments are parallel, the two segments are parallel to the same segment. Segment PQ and segment AB are parallel to the same segment DC. So we can say segment PQ is parallel to segment AB. So from 4 and 5. Now in triangle ADR, I already told PQ is equal to half of the third side. So PQ is equal to half of the third side DR. Now DR can be written as DC plus CR because C lies between D and R. Now from equation 2, we can substitute instead of CR AB. So we get half of DC plus AB, which is otherwise half of AB plus DC. So PQ is equal to half of AB plus DC. Now question number 9. In the adjoining figure, quadrilateral ABCD is a trapezium. AB is parallel to DC. Points M and N are midpoints of diagonals AC and DB respectively. We have to prove that MN is parallel to AB. The figure is given. You have to make some construction. Join D and M. First of all, join D and M. Then extend segment DM to meet segment AB at point E such that E lies between A and B. So segment AB is parallel to segment DC and segment AC is their transversal is given. Therefore, we have the alternate angles to be congruent. Angle CAB will be congruent to angle ACD. Therefore, the CAB is otherwise angle MAE and ACD is otherwise angle MCD. Take it to be equation 1. Now, the reason is M lies between C and A and E lies between A and B. Look at the construction properly here. You can understand now. Therefore, angle MAE is congruent to angle MCD, we have taken as equation number 1. Now, in triangle AME and triangle CMD, see triangle AME and triangle CMD. You have the vertically opposite angles. Angle AME is congruent to angle CMD because they are vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles are congruent. Segment AM is congruent to segment CM because M is the midpoint of segment AC. Angle MAE is congruent to angle MCD, that is from equation 1. Therefore, triangle AME is congruent to because the side is the included side between the two angles. Now find out the corresponding sides of congruent triangles. Segment ME is congruent to segment MD. Therefore, point M is the midpoint of segment DE. The segments are congruent means the lengths are equal. So ME is equal to MD. Now look at the figure. ME is equal to MD. So point M is the midpoint of segment DE. Take it to be equation number 2. Now take triangle DEB. From the figure I have a detached triangle DEB. Points M and N are the midpoints of segment DE and segment DB respectively. Given and from equations 2. Now look at the figure. Now don't look at the second figure. Look at the original figure. Previous one, first figure. In triangle DEB, because I have taken the wrong triangle here, that triangle DEB you have to see. See the first figure only. In triangle DEB, points M and N are the midpoints of segment DE and segment DB respectively. We have two midpoints. So what I have taught you, you have to use the midpoint theorem. When you have two midpoints, you have to use the midpoint theorem. For the midpoint theorem, we have two midpoints, because the segment joining the midpoints of any two sides of the triangle is parallel to the third side, and half of it is the midpoint theorem. So the first part of the midpoint theorem is the segment joining the midpoints of any two sides of the triangle is parallel to the third side. So segment MN is parallel to segment EB. See the first figure. Segment MN is parallel to segment EB, because in triangle DEB, EB is the third side. So the line joining the midpoints is, line segment joining the midpoints is MN. So MN is parallel to EB by midpoint theorem. Now since E lies between A and B, segment MN is parallel to segment AB.